Y'all get ready.
Yes, you get ready.
You want the latest news in the streets? Join us and tune in for the tea. Breaking news with integrity. So tell your friends and your family.
It's the Lovelyti TV show.
Bringing you good tea and good
vibes. It's the Lovelyti TV show.
Be sure to share, like, and subscribe.
Hey, Tea Sippers. So today has obviously been a busy Friday. Like I said, I'm getting back in my live recording bag. I know a few people were like, oh my God, she's doing a live stream. I'm like, no, I'm just, you know, back on camera after all these years. So anyways, I want to come on here and talk about the Jeannie Mai situation, because when I tell you she is getting drugged all up and down social media, we were having a good old kiki in the Discord about this situation. If you guys do not know, she's currently trending because all of a sudden this, you know, what were they calling her? Fit, fun, and friendly. You know what I'm saying? This submissive wife, everybody was giving her props. Remember Kevin Samuels said that, you know, all high value men would choose Jeannie Mai over Lonnie Love because Jeannie's, you know, fit, fun, and friendly. She's cute. She's submissive. Well, Miss Submissive is all of a sudden having a change of heart, okay? So what is going on is that basically she's currently trending because she's asking the courts to hold off on the prenuptial agreement. She's claiming that she didn't get enough time to read it before she signed it and that it should be invalid. So I'm gonna go ahead and read to you guys the article in which she said this, so check this out. So it's been reported Jeannie Mai is requesting the court hold off on enforcing her prenup with Jeezy, saying that she did not have enough time to review it before signing. The talk show host filed the request on Thursday afternoon in Fulton County Superior Court, asking the judge to either deny Jeezy's motion to enforce the prenuptial agreement or at least hold off on enforcing it until the parties can exchange information about it. In the documents obtained by TMZ, Jeannie Mai says the prenup process was so quick, they started negotiating just 5 days before she walked down the aisle. She doesn't think she was able to do proper due diligence on the agreement. She also says she didn't go through Jeezy's financial disclosures with a fine-tooth comb to make sure that she was getting a fair deal, and that this raises significant concerns about the adequacy and thoroughness of the due diligence process, okay? So that is what she had to say, and when I tell you, folks are currently dragging her all over social media. I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys some of these tweets and comments. People are not here for Jeannie Mai's foolishness whatsoever. All right, so Erica says, Jeannie Mai talked about she didn't read the prenup thoroughly. That's what happens when you hurry up and buy.
Hurry up and buy! Hurry up and buy!
So this has over 4,000 retweets. Everybody's cracking up at this. Some of the replies back to her tweet, somebody says, that man got his Blasian baby and left. He married her for the razzle dazzle. Another person said she didn't read the full menu because she prefers dark meat on the side. Somebody else says, excuse me, not reading a prenup thoroughly is insane. That's a major commitment. Somebody else says, I can't take this seriously. While these two say, right, it's like, why would you sign anything without reading it? If there's one thing you always do, you always read legal documents. Always. Now, in my personal opinion, it's hard for me to feel bad for her. At the end of the day, I feel like she wanted to upstage her ex-husband, you know what I'm saying, Freddie. Because we all know Freddie moved on, he had a beautiful daughter, and he even called Jeannie trash because of the way that she treated him and everything else. And I think she was like in such a race to show people that she got herself, you know, her dark meat on the side. She got her man, Jeezy. And we all know Jeezy was worth way more than she was worth financially, right? So for her, it was a really good look. He was also a lot richer than her last husband. But foolish her, she ran to go get married and just foolishly signed the prenup without doing her due diligence. And now she wants to play crazy. But what's even more funny is this is the same woman who 3 years ago was, you know, running all over her show talking about, you know, she's going to be submissive to her husband and people need to be submissive and this, this, and that. So let me go ahead and rewind that back. This was just Jeannie telling the world that she was going to be submissive to her husband. Check this out.
I'm going to say right here that I, Jeannie Mai, going into my marriage, I want to submit to my man. Let me explain.
Okay, before you start feeling some type of way, Jeannie Mai is just letting people know she doesn't want to be the leader when it comes to her marriage with her fiance, Jeezy.
Girls, it's tiring being the boss of me. It's tiring leading all the time.
It's tired to be the boss all the time.
The real co-host is tired of making so many decisions when it comes to her career. She likes the idea of her man taking the lead at home.
I'm a very dominant woman. I own my business, I lead my teams, I played my own manager, my own publicist, my own lawyer when I didn't have money to have those people. So I make the decisions in my life. When I come home, I like the idea that my man leads us.
And she's making one thing clear, being submissive doesn't mean she's lower than her husband.
That doesn't mean that in this case, Jay makes all the decisions for us. That doesn't mean that when he says, how are we spending our money or where are we moving, that I just say, yes, sir, or yes, your honor. Like, it's not that. It's a, you know what? I think that we would do best here. I want to do this. And he takes the decision. He formulates it with our overall vision, and he leads us, and I like to submit to that.
Jeannie said how she grew up definitely played a factor in deciding what type of marriage she wants to have.
My mom has a very strong force, and she took over a lot of decisions in the household to the point that my dad, unless it was always going to be a fight, he was like, you know what, go ahead, whatever you want to decide, go ahead, and I'm just going to do me. And that causes a wedge, and I can have that tendency. I'm just saying, for me, I can have that tendency to follow like my mom because it's what I grew up in and I saw it.
But we have a feeling this whole submissive thing is working for Jeannie and Jeezy. I mean, hello, the man bought her a billboard proving he knows how to lead.
I just want to wish you luck on your big night tonight. Got a little something for you.
Yep, Jeannie is currently competing on this season of Dancing with the Stars.
All right, child, we've seen enough. So any damn ways, I find it very, very interesting that not even a few years ago, she was talking about this whole submissive situation. Now, there's nothing wrong with submitting to your man. I don't think there's anything wrong with that. Even in the Bible, there's not supposed to be two head of households. A man is supposed to lead the household. But the problem is you need to be a man worth leading. I'm not going to submit to somebody who does not have themselves together, who does not make me feel secure financially, mentally, physically, all of that stuff. And that's where a lot of women today find themselves. Like, they're trying to find, they want a man to lead, but again, it has to be the right type of man. You know, I get her wanting to submit to her husband, but was this the right type of husband to submit to? You know, but I just find it very interesting that now she wants to renege on the prenup. That's not how it works. The only thing you're really entitled to is child support. She did make sure to secure the bag with that baby. But as far as her now being upset and saying that, you know, oh, she didn't know what she was signing, she needs to go over with the fine-tooth comb, unless she was under duress and he put a, you know, a pow-pow to her head, I'm not buying that. You know what I'm saying? What it is she's mad, she's bitter, she has egg on her face. Remember, they was riding around on that damn bicycle built for two, honey, okay? And now all of that is gone. This whole facade that they were both trying to put out there to the public is gone. And, you know, she's salty. So she feels like, you know what, I need some of that bag. And let's not forget, Hollywood is really struggling right now, okay? There's not a whole lot of gigs. She no longer has her talk show. I know she has her YouTube channel, like all these celebrities out here. I know he has a book and, you know, I guess he's working on music. But the money is not moneying. And that's for everybody. That's not just me talking shit about celebrities. It's everybody. There's so many layoffs happening right now. It is insane. From Sports Illustrated to Google, these tech companies, a lot of people are being laid off. So I think that's part of why she's trying to renege on the prenup and go for the bag. But I don't think that she really has a leg to stand on, because if she signed legal paperwork, like I said, unless she can prove that she was under some type of duress, there's nothing she can do about the situation. So it's going to be very interesting to see how this plays out. But again, you know, everybody was acting like she was so above, you know, being a gold digger and, you know, she's fit, fun, and friendly, you know, all that shit. And now we're seeing her true colors, okay? So while everybody's trying to act like she was so much better than Lonnie Love, Lonnie Love is probably somewhere laid up with her little white husband, honey, drinking hot cocoa, sipping slow, and watching this fuckery unfold. Because remember, she didn't invite Lonnie to the wedding. But that's a whole nother video. So anyways, y'all, let's go ahead and get the discussion popping. Go ahead and leave a comment. Let me know your thoughts on this entire messy situation. concerning Jeannie Mai wanting to put a hold on the prenup. She basically feels like, hey, you know, I didn't know what I signed. Do you agree with her? Do you feel like she has a case? Do you think she has the right to renege on the prenup? Or do you feel like, you know what? No, it's too late. You don't get to, you know, renege on the prenup. That's what was set in stone before the marriage. So too bad, so sad. So I can't wait to read your comments down below. Make sure you guys hit this video with a like. Feel free to share the video. And most importantly, make sure you still subscribe to the channel. And I will talk to y'all later. Deuces.
If you want the latest news in the streets, join us and tune in for the tea. Breaking news with integrity. So tell your friends and your family.
It's the Lovelyti TV Show.
Bringing you good tea and good vibes.
It's the Lovelyti TV Show.
Be sure to share, like, and subscribe.